Welcome to the unit overview video for Math 1, Unit 1, Sequences. The focus of this unit is to explore the key features of arithmetic and geometric sequences through multiple representations. Here's a quote that you can reflect on as we begin this course and this unit. Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It is about understanding. William Paul Thurston. The mathematics curriculum that you will be using in this course is focused on conceptual understanding, which at times this year will cause you to feel challenged and stretched, but the reward will be worth it if you persevere. The big ideas for this unit include analyzing and comparing arithmetic and geometric sequences. For arithmetic sequences, you will find that there is a pattern of a constant difference between terms, whereas with geometric sequences, you will find that there is a pattern of a common ratio between terms. Key mathematical tools that we will use in this unit include using multiple representations of these sequences. Multiple representations include creating tables, graphs, and diagrams, writing recursive formulas and explicit equations to represent these relationships, and interpreting them in context. Here's an example of an arithmetic sequence in table form. The common difference for this sequence is 3 because the bottom row of values in the table are increasing by 3. A recursive formula would look like this. F of n equals f of n minus 1 plus 3, starting from f of 0 equals 4, or x sub n equals x sub n minus 1 plus 3, starting from x sub 0 equals 4. You will be exposed to different types of notations that mathematicians use to represent recursive formulas. They are equivalent representations, and we will use both in this unit. An explicit equation would look like f of n equals 3n plus 4. And a graph of this sequence would look like what you see here in the lower right of your screen. Here's an example of a geometric sequence in table form. The common ratio for this sequence is 3, because the bottom row of values is increasing by a factor of 3. A recursive formula would look like f of n equals f of n minus 1 times 3, f of 0 equals 4, or x sub n equals x sub n minus 1 times 3, starting from x sub 0 equals 4. An explicit equation for this geometric sequence would look like f of n equals 4 times 3 to the n power, and a graph of this sequence would look like what you see here in the lower right of your screen. Here's a list of key vocabulary terms for this unit that will help us describe arithmetic and geometric sequences. A few of these words may already be familiar to you. Here are some key skills needed to be successful with the content of this unit. You should be able to add, subtract, multiply, and divide with real numbers, including fractions. You should be able to solve one- and two-step linear equations. And you should be able to graph a set of points given a table. In addition to your teacher and school-based resources, there are several additional resources available. The Ready, Set, Go homework help videos are housed in the Canvas site for your class. You can access these in Canvas using your student login. If you do not know how to log into Canvas, ask your teacher for help. The K-12 Math Resources website, which can be found on your school's website, includes additional support items such as unit and lesson overviews, videos overviewing the tasks, essential vocabulary, the North Carolina standards for each unit, learning targets for each lesson, and extra practice problems. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy this unit and your entire Math 1 course.